Hey guys, so I've got about five minutes to talk about this, but you know, I was watching a couple of videos yesterday. They came recommended to me through YouTube, and one of them was by the Turtle Nexus channel, and I think even Turtle Fever did the same one, or I think that's the other channel's name. And they basically asked the question about who is Ninjara. Now, I've done my own video on it. I even remastered that video to 4K. I might consider remastering it again to 8K in the future. But what was interesting about the video is not only did they go into detail who created Ninjara for the TMNT Archie book and everything, and where she went after, you know, her character left the book, and, you know, the fact that she was planned to come back, and even, you know, to the point that they said that the creators, the writers and the artists of the original Archie series had brought her back during the IDW run for like a special tribute issue or something like that. But, you know, but the one question that I think they finally answered for a lot of fans was, you know, what's her status? You know, like, you know, where is she right now? Well, ironically, they acknowledged that basically Ninjara is owned not by Stephen Murphy or Chris Allen, no. She's not owned by those individuals in any shape or form, because this is actually a tale of the fact that they did the one thing that a lot of people accuse Archie of not doing, Archie Comics of not doing, when, you know, they had Ken Penders on board to so that they could potentially avoid the mess they went through. You see, what they noted is that Steve Murphy and Chris Allen, I think, had signed contracts, basically, that, you know, when it was all said and done, had resulted in, you know, characters like Ninjara, characters that they would create, environments they would create, stories that they would create, would result in all of that reverting over to the people that own the TMNT license. And in this case right now, it's Viacom, you know, the people that own Nickelodeon, Paramount, CBS, the like. So that there was an interesting tidbit, because when they brought up the fact that Ninjara had been, re-debuted, if you will, or made a return appearance in, like I said, a retelling of a classic Archie TMNT series, you know, still as Raphael's girlfriend, it really did kind of raise the questions of like, how is that possible? And then when they mentioned that she's owned by Viacom, you know, it did that right there pretty much sealed the deal to me that, hey, there is a possibility she can come back. Because one of the stories people want to see get the treatment for a return, or at least finished, is the Forever War. And the Forever War is basically something that apparently does have some pages already done, not just the ones that are, that were already out there, like the first six pages or something like that, where the turtles are training in the sewers, a portal opens, and a Shredder kicking and, you know, throwing out and kicking out the beaten future Donatello or anything like that. No. It was actually some other images where we saw that future, and we saw Ninjara along with that alien girl, or that spiritual alien girl from the Jerusalem story arc that they did, and or the Ambius War, as they called it, Ambius War, whatever it was called, where Michelangelo accidentally temporarily got blinded at the end. You know, they showed her, they showed two, I think they had April in the background, she had a patch on her eye or something, and then somebody else. So, you know, the Forever War is a story people want to see make a return, or at least get completed, and it would have shown the return officially of Ninjara to the status quo. Whether or not in this story that would have happened originally back when the comic was under the Archie license, whether or not it would have had a return as, you know, Raphael's love interest is another story. I'm pretty sure it would have, because, you know, they wouldn't have put her as such in that little one-shot return tribute, if you will, several years ago. But yeah, you know, I got to give credit where credit is due to the Turtle Nexus and to the other TMNT channel, I think called Fever, giving us an idea of where the status of Ninjara, Yumiko, Umiko, whatever you call it, stands right now. And hopefully because of that, you know, we might see a return of the character in the near future. But let me know what your thoughts are, guys, on, you know, the current status of Ninjara, Yumiko, Umiko, if you will. And do you think we'll see her return? And also, do you think we'll see her return not just with the possible finishing to Forever War, if should that happen, but do you think we'll see her return in any future TMNT content? Let me know down below. Comment if you like. Live chat during the premiere or super chats are open, it would be appreciated. And until next time, guys, my bus to go to work is here, and I'm out.